Hello everyone. In this lecture video, we will discuss about the thermodynamic analysis of turbojet engine. From the previous lecture videos, we already discussed about the ideal TS diagram of the turbojet engine without the afterburner configuration. So shortly, in ideal process, the diffuser and compressor comes under the isentropic compression, the burner has a constant pressure heat supply process, and finally, the turbine and nozzle are comes under the isentropic expansion process. The next slide shows the actual TS diagram of a turbojet engine. In this diagram, the components diffuser, compressor, turbine as well as nozzle are comes under the non-isentropic process because the entropy varies from the constant values. As well as the combustion chamber have the losses due to the pressure losses and so on. The reason behind these non-isentropic values and incomplete combustion are created due to the losses present in the particular components. Let us see the reasons behind the components, that is the component losses, by one by one. The first device is called the diffuser. Ideally, the flow in the diffuser is uniform and the streamlines are smooth. But due to unfavorable pressure gradient, the boundary layer on the valve tends to grow quickly and can separate. This flow separation creates valve shear, boundary layer turbulence, and internal free stream turbulence. Due to these viscous effects, the flow becomes a non-isentropic one. Also, the losses can occur because of the flow enters the diffuser. That is, due to the supersonic flow, it creates a shock waves outside the plane of the diffuser inlet. Whether the shocks are created, the flow becomes a non-isentropic one. The next component is the compressor. Once again, in the ideal case, the flow was assumed as isentropic. Here, for the compressor, each row of plates acts like a diffuser. Therefore, an unfavorable pressure gradient is developed again, which can lead to separation as well as the viscous wakes and reduce the performance. Next, the flow velocities are high at the regions of transonic or supersonic flows. These can lead to partial choking in some of the passages or shocks. We know that the shocks are highly non-isentropic process. That is the non-isentropic one. The next device is called the combustion chamber. Okay, ideally the gas goes to the complete combustion, but due to non-idealities cause the losses in the total temperature. These non-idealities are categorized as it may be due to imperfect combustion or it may be due to the pressure losses. The incomplete combustion or imperfect combustion takes place because it may be a poor or ineffective mixing of fuel and air, or if the cold air is injected to the combustion chamber, or that is the cold flow injected to the combustor, and the composition of fuel, because if it have any additives and the presence of any impurities. As well as the pressure losses are occur due to the primary combustion chamber has the swirlers, flame holders and turbulence generators, and it creates the obstruction to the flow. The next one is that the primary combustion chamber consists of number of small holes called orifices. It is used to distribute the air. So due to the air exposed to these small orifices, the total pressure is lost. The next device is turbine. Ideally, a turbine operates at isentropic process, but actually the compressor has several losses and it contributes the overall loss in the turbine also. Also, these pressure drops through the turbine creates a partial choking than a compressor. Due to the turbine blade cooling, the enthalpy of the fluid becomes low and it comes in the non-isentropic process. The final component is called nozzle. Again, for the ideal case, the entropy remains constant, that is isentropic one. But due to the friction in boundary layer, free stream turbulence, as well as the shocks in the nozzle and flow separation creates the increment of entropy. Therefore, in actual case, the process becomes non-isentropic one. So this slide shows the actual and ideal combined TS diagram of a turbojet engine. So to make the difference between the actual as well as the ideal passes, we may consider the dash values, that is the 01 dash, 02 dash, 04 dash and 5 dash is an ideal value, and A01, 02, 03, 04 and 5, it's an actual value of the turbojet engine components. The next one is the thermodynamic analysis of turbojet engine. The first device, it's a diffuser. We may go for the diffuser efficiency formula now. The diffuser efficiency is the ratio between ideal power to the actual power. Why I'm mentioned here, it's ideal power to the actual power means, in the diffuser, due to the losses, we need more actual power than the ideal power, that is non-isentropic one. So therefore, the efficiency of diffuser becomes, for the ideal power, it may MCP into T01 dash minus TA, and actual power is MCP into T01 minus TA. By cancelling MCP, we'll get the diffuser efficiency is equal to T01 dash minus TA divided by T01 minus TA. The next one is that stagnation to static temperature ratio, because in the diffuser, the static value is converted to the stagnation one. So therefore, we may go for the stagnation temperature to the static temperature ratio. That is what we need to consider the steady flow energy equation. In the left hand side, I have taken the stagnation value, on the right hand side, I have taken the static value. So from the steady flow energy equation, I took the enthalpy as well as the dynamic pressure component. So that is what the stagnation we have in H0 plus C0 square divided by 2, and the static H plus C square by 2. But actually C0 is equal to 0 because it's not a stagnation component. So therefore H0 is equal to H plus C square divided by 2. Already we know that H is equal to the product of Cp into T. The Cp is nothing like that specific heat at constant pressure, and the T is nothing like that, it's an absolute temperature. So we may rewrite the previous equation like Cp into T0 is equal to Cp into T plus C square divided by 2. Dividing this equation by Cp, we'll get T0 is equal to T plus C square divided by 2 Cp. So by converting this formula to the diffuser, we'll get T01 is equal to TA plus CA square divided by 2 Cp. As well as we know that Cp is equal to gamma R divided by gamma minus 1 thermodynamically. So therefore, substituting the gamma R divided by gamma minus 1 value into the previous Cp value, we'll get T01 is equal to TA plus gamma minus 1 divided by 2 into gamma into CA square. Or dividing this equation by TA, we'll get T01 by TA is equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 divided by 2 into CA square divided by gamma R TA. The gamma is a specific heat ratio and R is a gas constant. And we know that Mach number is equal to the velocity of an object divided by velocity of sound. Therefore, M is equal to C divided by root of gamma RT, or M square is equal to C square divided by gamma RT. So by substituting this C square divided by gamma RT value into the previous equation, we'll get T01 by TA is equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 divided by 2 into MA square. As well as the isentropic relation will become T01 dash divided by TA is equal to P01 by PA whole power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma. Now we may go for the next device. It's a compressor. Like diffuser, again the compressor efficiency is equal to ideal power divided by actual power. Or ideally we have an ideal power value MCP into T02 dash minus T01, and actual value we have an MCP into T02 minus T01. Again, by cancelling MCP value, it becomes the compressor efficiency is equal to T02 dash minus T01 divided by T02 minus T01. The next one is that compressor pressure ratio. It is the stagnation pressure ratio, that is, it is the ratio between exit stagnation pressure to the inlet stagnation pressure, that is P02 divided by P01. As well as the isentropic relation for the compressor becomes T02 dash divided by T01 is equal to P02 divided by P01 whole power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma, or it's simply a compressor pressure ratio whole power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma. The next one is a combustion chamber. So due to the pressure losses, the exit pressure of the combustion chamber is not equal to the inlet pressure. Ideally, it's an constant pressure process, but due to the losses, it may be not one.
So therefore, your exit pressure is equal to 1 minus delta PB into P02. The delta PB is nothing less than it's a combustion chamber pressure loss, and there may be a value of some percentage. As well as, if you want to find out the value for mass rate of fuel, we may go for the energy balance equation. The energy balance equation is not one. It's nothing like that. It's a product of combustion chamber efficiency into mass rate of fuel into heating value of fuel is equal to MA CPG into T03 minus T02 plus MF CPG into T03. Here I have mentioned CP for the gas value, because in the combustion chamber, the air is converted to the gas. The MA is nothing like that, it's mass rate of air, and MF is nothing like that, it's mass rate of fuel. And T03 is an exit temperature of the combustion chamber, and T02 is a inlet temperature of the combustion chamber. The next one is called the turbine. The turbine efficiency becomes actual power to the ideal power, because due to the losses of enthalpy, that efficiency equation will becomes actual power to the ideal power. Again, the actual power value is MCP into T03 minus T04, and the ideal power value is MCP into T03 minus T04 dash. By cancelling, the MCP value becomes T03 minus T04 divided by T03 minus T04 dash for the turbine efficiency value. And then, if we suppose want to find out the value of T04, that is the turbine exit temperature, we need to equal the compressor odor as well as the turbine odor. Eventually, the turbine is a device which is used to operate the compressor by connecting a same shaft. So whenever the turbine works, the compressor also works. So we may rewrite the compressor odor as CPA into T02 minus T01, and the turbine odor as CPG into T03 minus T04. So before enter to the combustion chamber, your inlet flow is an air, but after leaving the combustion chamber, your fluid becomes a gas. That is what we have mentioned, the CPA for the compressor, and have mentioned the CPG for the turbine. As well as, if the mechanical efficiency is given, the mechanical efficiency is the ratio between the compressor work done to the turbine work done. So therefore, we may rewrite this equation. Mechanical efficiency is equal to CPA into T02 minus T01 divided by CPG into T03 minus T04. As far as the isentropic relation for the turbine comes, T04 dash divided by T03 is equal to P04 divided by P03 whole power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma. The final component is nozzle. Likewise, the turbine, the nozzle efficiency also the ratio between actual power to the ideal power, that is MCP into T04 minus T5 divided by MCP into T04 minus T5 dash. By cancelling the MCP value, we'll get nozzle efficiency is equal to T04 minus T5 divided by T04 minus T5 dash. As well as, to find out the exit velocity from the nozzle, we may go for the energy equation between the states 0, 4 and 5. That is what stagnation enthalpy H04 is equal to H5, that is the static enthalpy plus the dynamic pressure C5 squared divided by 2. We know that H is equal to CP into temperature, therefore CPG into T04 is equal to CPG into T5 plus C5 squared divided by 2. Dividing this equation by CPG, will get T04 is equal to T5 plus C5 squared divided by 2 CPG, or C5 is equal to root of 2 into CPG into T04 minus T5. Also, we may rewrite this equation by substituting T04 minus T5 is equal to efficiency of the nozzle into T04 minus T5 dash. We'll get exit velocity C5 is equal to root of 2 into CPG into nozzle efficiency into T04 minus T5 dash. The next one is that the stagnation to static temperature ratio. Likewise, the diffuser, we may write T04 by T5 is equal to 1 plus gamma minus and by 2 into M5 square. As well as the isentropic relation becomes P04 by P5 is equal to T04 divided by T5 dash whole power gamma divided by gamma minus 1. By substituting the equations A and B into the equation C, will becomes the pressure ratio P5 divided by P04 is equal to 1 divided by 1 plus gamma minus 1 divided by 2 into M5 square minus 1 plus the nozzle efficiency whole divided by nozzle efficiency and the whole power gamma delta by gamma minus 1. The P5 is your exit static pressure from the nozzle, and P04 is a inlet stagnation to the nozzle. So this equation is applicable for the non-choked nozzle, whether your exit pressure is less than your inlet pressure, that is the ambient pressure, your nozzle is an unchoked one. If the nozzle is choked, your exit pressure is greater than the inlet pressure, that is the ambient pressure, as well as if the nozzle is choked, your exit Mach number becomes unity, that is the sonic one. Therefore, your pressure ratio will becomes P5 is called as P star, that is it mentioned the choked one. So therefore, P star divided by P04 is equal to 1 plus 1 minus gamma divided by nozzle efficiency into 1 plus gamma whole power gamma divided by gamma minus 1. As well as the temperature ratio becomes T04 divided by T star is equal to 1 plus gamma divided by 2. Thank you.